Shalom and welcome to another installment of Elders of GMS, giving all praises to Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai. Today's topic is going to be entitled "Go to the Sellers and Buy." A go to the sellers and buy, debunking false doctrines. And basically, we've been battling against these other Israelite groups and the black consciousness groups. And basically, it's like a free-for-all on pretty much all of them. We're going to see where the Spirit leads us. But anyway, I have some... let's read that scripture. This is quoted from a scripture.
This is the book of Matthew 25, verse 9. But the wise answered, saying, "Not so, lest there be not enough for..."
No, you got to go up about maybe another verse or two.
This is verse 5. Matthew 25, 5. While the bridegroom tarried, they all slumbered and slept. And at midnight there was a cry made, "Behold, the bridegroom cometh, go ye out to meet him."
The bridegroom is the Lord himself, Yahweh Shai. And there was a cry made, the bridegroom cometh, go ye out and meet him. Now the cry was made, or is being made, by this is actually a prophecy. So Matthew, the Lord speaking, all right, concerning a prophecy that's happening now, 2,000 years later. And basically he's talking about the men of the Most High, the elect, that are going out there teaching the word and getting people ready for the Lord coming back. Go ahead.
Then all those virgins arose and trimmed their lamps. And the foolish said unto the wise, "Give us of your oil, for our lamps are gone out."
Yeah, that's why you got all these other Israelite splinter groups, mainly from one west. All right? You got these splinter groups here that's, they really don't know these scriptures, man. You know, when you deal with them and you meet them on a comment board, or they'll teach a certain scripture or a certain topic, and we'll come back and we'll say that they're going off on it, and then we'll break it down the right way, and they basically got a problem with that. Now, when you really go head-to-head with these guys when it comes to these scriptures, they really don't know what the hell they're talking about. Mm-hmm. And that includes Nate, that includes Bunyamyan, HODC, that includes Comfy, that includes all of them, man. And that's why we're the only group that says that we have 100% truth. Okay? Mm-hmm. Right, go ahead.
But the wise answered, saying, "Not so, lest there be not enough for us and you. But go ye rather to them that sell and buy for yourselves."
You know, speak. I gotta check something.
Right. So basically, that's what's going on right now. You know, like Elder Tar has mentioned this before. You know, we don't have time to go back and reteach these guys all over again. That's right. That's why the scriptures say, "Go ye rather to the buyers, to them that sell and buy for yourselves." You know, you have to. If the Spirit of the Lord is with you, you're gonna figure it out. You know, our job is basically to keep teaching so that the elect can be sealed. You know, our main goal right now is to teach the elect, and that's it. You know, we can't go back, you know, to them guys that are fell out, you know, that are teaching different doctrines, that are going off, and sit there and try to break things down to them and explain to them how it's broken down. We don't have time for that, man. You got something else to go for?
Yeah, like that Cornelius issue.
That's right.
You know, that's one issue. And also the scriptures say that this knowledge is like living water.
That's right.
So living water keeps flowing.
Right.
You know, and either you flow with it or you get left behind.
That's it.
So just like Elder Ramlop said, we don't have time to go into, the bare specifics of certain mysteries, deep dark sayings, like the Cornelius issue.
Right.
You know?
Now, you like the scriptures say, you got to go to the sellers and buy it. If the Spirit of the Lord is working with you, the Lord will put the Spirit on in you to get it.
Yeah,
you know, and it ain't like you don't have videos out there to watch. That we've done plenty of videos through the Spirit of Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai. There's plenty of videos out there, you know, breaking down everything the right way. Going into the books of Genesis, the books of Revelation, you know, the books of Daniel, you know, and all prophecies, parables, you know, and different breakdowns of the scriptures. They're all out there, you know. But some of you is out of pride. And really, a lot of you, you're just blind, man. You don't even know that you're blind. That's the funny thing about it, like HODC12. And that dude, Ben, man, you're a proud devil, man. That's what you are, man. You're a proud devil. And I'm going to say it boldly. No, because you're proud, man. You got that super proud spirit. Then you got that toothpick, you know, to spite Elder Tahar. The Lord's going to deal with you, man. You got that. The Lord said one thing he hates is a proud look.
Yeah, he said to spite Elder Tahar. Really what he's doing is showing himself to be the freaking moron that we already know him to be, you know, having a toothpick in his mouth. I got a scripture to back you up. This is the book of Jeremiah, the 3rd chapter, and also shows that he was cut. Now, all them years ago when he came to the school on the pretense of stealing the school up in Connecticut, yes, he did walk in the building. And yes, he did, and he was mean mugging brothers, acting like he was some sort of tough guy. And he did have a toothpick in his mouth.
Yep. And all you kept hearing was like,
and he's sucking on that toothpick like he was retarded, which he is retarded. All right? This is Jeremiah 3:15. It says, and I will give you pastors according to mine heart, which shall feed you with knowledge and understanding.
That's right. And that's what the Lord set up. You know, the Lord's not going to set up his men and then they only have 50% of the truth or 60 or 70% of the truth. The Lord set up his men and they're going to have 100% truth. That's why I said he will give thee pastors that will feed thee according to the heart of the Most High, according to his words.
Yeah, Yahweh Shai had 100% truth, you know?
Matter of fact, yeah, the disciples said that.
Yahweh Shai, he had 100% truth. All right, this is the book of 1 John 2:20. It says, but ye have an unction from the Holy One, and you know all things.
That's right.
That sounds like 100% truth to me.
That's right. And the 100% truth, you know, as we've been saying, Elder Tar has been saying it, you know, that the 100% truth, meaning we know the breakdowns of these scriptures. Whatever we don't know about, whatever mysteries the Lord haven't revealed to us yet, as far as other things are concerned, we don't know about those things. But as far as the scriptures are concerned, the breakdowns of the scriptures, we have 100% truth in that. You know? When the scriptures say that we know in part, we prophesy in part, meaning that we don't know everything that took place. As far as from our creation, you know, the Lord didn't detail everything down in his book. What he wanted us to know, the 100% that he wanted us to know, he put it in his book.
Yep, I got you on that one. This is the book of Deuteronomy 29:29. It says, the secret things belong unto the Lord our power.
That's right.
But those things which are revealed belong unto us and to our children forever.
Right.
That we may do all the words of this law.
That's it. So whatever the Lord revealed to us here, that's what we know about. The scripture in Corinthians where it speaks about we know in part, we prophesy in part, mean that we don't know everything that took place. Even the scriptures say that Yahweh Shai, if the works that he did were to be written, the whole world couldn't contain those books. You know why? Because he did so many great miracles and so many great works.
Mm-hmm.
I got a quick precept real quick.
Yep.
This is John, St. John chapter 16, verse 29. His disciples said unto him, lo, now speakest thou plainly and speakest no proverb. Now are we sure that thou knowest all things.
100% truth.
That's right. And needest not that any man should ask thee. By this we believe that thou camest forth from the Most High.
Yeah, and that's how you know Yahweh Shemiah Shai is working with GMS. Because we're bold enough to say we have 100% truth. And none of you morons out there can disprove us, man.
That's right.
All right? This is the book of Amos 3:7. It says, surely the Lord power will do nothing, but he revealeth his secret unto his servants, the prophets.
That's right. And that's what it said, surely the Lord power will do nothing, but he revealeth his secrets unto his servants, the prophets. That's why we're out there prophesying about the mark of the beast. You know, about the destruction of America, about America being Babylon the Great, Esau being a so-called white man, and different things that are taking place on the planet.
Yeah, and really, we're the main group out there that's prophesying.
That's right.
Which the word prophesy means to say before. Really, all them other groups, they're not really... Okay, let's take a look at Bagwash, right? 14th Street Moron. Is he really prophesying? No, he's not prophesying. All he's doing is making videos trying to debunk GMS. All right, General Gehenna, is he really prophesying? He's yelping and yelling, like Elder Tar said. He's yelping and yelling, all right? HODC, are they really prophesying? They're not prophesying. Bubble Eye Blackfish, is he really prophesying? So really the main group out there that's prophesying is GMS, man. So if you want to get into prophecy, you got to watch GMS. You can't watch them other groups.
Well, they are going to start watching us. They watch us any damn way, but they mad. But when this thing really starts opening up, you're gonna be watching our videos. Trust me. Like I give an example that these guys are not on no level. They haven't grown. Going to HODC. Now you got Barack teaching that Barack Obama is the Antichrist. But now they're bugging out because I made a video countering that, you know? And showed him speaking it, so he can't say, well, I never said that. I got you on video, man. Then you got Fopi. They don't know what's going on. They're just tagging along behind you guys and behind Zabak, like you guys have the knowledge or the know the scriptures. But the scriptures that you don't know, the thing is, well, we don't got 100% knowledge. Even Barack said that. We ain't going to follow nobody that got 100% knowledge. Well, look, if I'm looking for the knowledge, I'm going for the guy with the 100%, not the guy with the 80%. Okay? Right. That was right. A stupid statement, okay?
That's right. That's right.
So we see you guys, man. We see that you don't have the oil. You clearly don't. Now Nate made a statement years ago when we were all together. He said that he had a dream that he lost the oil.
Right.
But at the end, he got it back.
Right.
That's the reason why I said Nate will come back. That don't mean he's going to come back. That's just my view on that situation, all right?
Okay.
Because that could just be a dream or it could have been like a vision, all right? But I know one thing, Nate is getting worse and worse, man.
Yeah.
And Nate, you're a double-minded man. Give me that in James. You're a double-minded man because you say one thing a year and a half, 2 years ago. Mm-hmm. But then 2 years later, you forgot that you said that, and then you come and you contradict what you said 2 years ago.
Kind of.
And we got that on video, all right? And we're going to show that video.
That's right.
Okay?
This is the book of James, chapter 1, verse 8. It says, a double-minded man is unstable in all his ways, meaning... it means just what it says, in all his ways. A double-minded man is unstable in all his ways, because one day he's going to be speaking about one thing, and the week later he'll come back and say something totally different that'll go against what he just said.
Well, we got the example. Yakanani put that video up. He showed you speaking to Hebrew years before. Yep. Then he shows the video where you say, you got to watch these slick-talking guys that go into the Hebrew. Right. Ebonics! You know, that clearly showed that you were a double-minded man, Nate.
That's right.
You know, and you're losing credibility day by day, Nate. You know, people are waking up to your shenanigans, man.
Yeah, Ringo TV, man. He did a big, like a 30-minute thing on you, a 20-minute thing. He cursing you guys out, man. But anyway, I'm going to show you the double-minded man, the double-minded man mandiness. Of your type. Whatever the hell that means. But anyway, let's roll that beautiful beam footage. Right, hold up.
So now, I made the statement. I said multicultural society is a danger to our people. Now, you might think I am a conspiracy theorist. One thing you'll find out about me, I am not a conspiracy theorist. A conspiracy theorist generally is a nut, a crazy person. There's a lot of conspiracy theorists on YouTube. Oh, you ever see the Muppets?
Children in sacrifices or used secret ceremonies or made revelings of strange lights.
You know what verse 23 is going into also? Like the Illuminati, they have those secret society where they give those sacrificial feasts. Sacrifices. Here again.
But whilst they slew their children in sacrifices,
they killed children like the 12 people. Now you might think I am a conspiracy theorist. One thing you'll find out about me, I am not a conspiracy theorist. A conspiracy theorist generally is a nut, a crazy person. There's a lot of conspiracy theorists on YouTube.
Yeah, you're one of them. You're one of them, guy. We got you, bro. And see, that's going to be on the show, but if somebody's going to take that clip and they're going to do something to it, yep. And watch how many people go. You're being revealed, my man. Yep. Okay? You're being revealed, bro. All right? Now, that's clip where he's called, you got conspiracy theorists that are nuts and all that. That's a clip from the video that he did that I'm waiting for him to finish it. Because people are saying, when you going to come up with the whole video? Well, it's going to be a while before, you know, we're in the works. Well, I can't wait till you do the whole thing. Because once I get it, man, I'm going to dice it and slice it and julienne it, man. You know? And it'll make you look stupid, man. Now, we just made you look stupid right there, man. You said conspiracy theorists are generally nuts. You got a lot of conspiracy theorists on YouTube. And then, lo and behold, that video that you made about 2 years ago or whatever, that was on YouTube.
Yeah.
And then you spoke about the Illuminati, how they kill children and all that, you know?
Yeah.
Now, when you watch that whole 10-minute video, it's like a teaser to another video. I think it's called Conspiracy Brothers Warning, all right? He basically said that you got nuts out there that's teaching that... mark of the beast is a chip, you know, pursuant to Revelation 13, 15 on down to the end. And you had mentioned that there's a group out there that said that the month of May 2014, that all European children are going to have to get that chip. And then there was another post of another site saying that was a hoax, all right? Well, there's a lot of examples of the mark of the beast being the chip, and these are from reliable sources. One of them is NBC News. Okay? Mm-hmm. Now hold up, brother. I'm just gonna go to the clip and then we're gonna go to the articles, okay?
Yep.
Can you hear me if I speak over that?
Okay.
Yeah, this is a video where this guy, look what he does. They're showing you that they push, look what he does.
When I was young, I would stand alone.
All right, this is from a Fat Joe video.
What you doing over here?
Some years ago.
Y'all going to the spot for Fat Joe. They got the ill house telescope coming through.
They got a club in here.
Yeah.
I ain't lying. Yo, true story.
Throw your hands in the air right now, man.
Feel it. That's it right there. You see him put his hand, the right hand there. That's what it is.
Embracing the age of Big Brother.
Baja Beach Club.
In Rotterdam, Holland, nightclub owner John Van Gallen has introduced a system of microchipping for his VIP patrons.
And this is not a hoax.
It's almost like barcoding people.
Yeah, it is.
And it's not a
because
conspiracy
every
theory,
chip
it's
got
a
number,
fact.
And the number corresponds to the name and the picture. That's the way it is, yeah. It is.
The microchip has to be surgically inserted under the skin, which means you'll have to have it cut out if you want it removed.
Now you notice it's on his
Did
left
it hurt
arm.
Getting the chip in?
But okay, the scriptures say right arm, and you're gonna see a lot
it
of
like
some
a
of them
of
on the left arm, and the others on the right arm.
Irving has had the chip for the past 4 years. Every time he buys a drink, he scans. And, like a human ATM, money comes off his account.
Sounds like a buy
you
and sell.
Feel like you're giving up a little
buy
bit of
and
your
sell.
Privacy, do you?
No. Nate said that's an RFID
it's nice,
is a tracking device. You can't buy and sell with it.
The first one in all the world. I have a
Checked
chip.
Out again, yeah. Nate.
Remember CCTV and monitoring. Thank you.
Big Brother is here to stay.
When we started this 1.5 year ago, we have people just want to do it for
This is
fun.
A different filming company.
Because it's new.
This is when he was a lot younger.
It's an amazing little device, which can mean there's no need for proof of ID or money to get in. It can all be done with tiny computer chips implanted in the flesh of Clubber's arms.
So what do these chips look like?
Got one here.
Yeah, I got one here for you. It's, like I told you, it's unbelievable. Got to be careful that I don't lose it. It's like a rice thing. It's
that's tiny, isn't it?
Really tiny.
Hey,
alles goed?
Hello. Hey, I'm with him. All right. So this is the scanning.
This is scanning. Normally you pay over here.
For clubbers with a chip, no cash is required, and getting in is simple.
Over there is my picture.
Yeah, right, yeah. Straight away.
Straight away.
And there's another benefit. When buying drinks, instead of paying with money, they can simply have the chips in their arms scanned. Their accounts with the club are automatically debited.
So you can buy and sell with RFID.
Chipping may be popular, but isn't it all a bit intrusive?
It's so simple. I think that within 20 years, when you get born, you will get a chip.
So that's a vision of the future. But are you worried how much your life at home and at work is being monitored and recorded already? You may not realize just how much you're being watched right now.
Technology on the cutting edge. We were interested today to hear that more than 100 law enforcement officials in Mexico are having microchips implanted in their arms.
Wait,
the chips allow a person to be scanned.
Maybe that's a hoax. Maybe that's a hoax. That's ABC News, man. That's ABC News. Let's go back to it. Got that, Nate?
Supermarket checkout. In Mexico, this will be one more tool in the fight against crime. Here's ABC's John McKenzie.
Mexico's attorney general and 160 of his deputies have had microchips implanted in their arms to control access to the country's new criminal investigation center. It is to provide access, said the attorney general, to the right people in exclusive areas where there is valuable, sensitive information.
You got both of his, the articles there.
The microchip, the size of a grain of rice, is injected under the skin and gives off a low-frequency radio wave. A scanner reads each chip's identification number to verify an official's security clearance.
The microchip
Notice
is
he has it on the right.
It's secure.
Right
on. No one can take your microchip and use it to their advantage to gain access to your facility.
The chip, developed by Applied Digital Solutions, is similar to those used in the U.S. to identify and return runaway dogs.
Yep, that's right. So... Now let's go to this guy. No, the other one. Okay. Let's read about him, and then we're going to read about him in that article, okay? Okay. Right, go ahead and read it, the name of the guy, and read the article.
All right.
That's from Wikipedia.
Yeah, this is from Wikipedia, entitled Rafael Macedo de la Concha. It says, Rafael Macedo de la Concha, born May 6, 1950 in Mexico City, is a Mexican army general and former attorney general in the cabinet of Vicente Fox, December 1st, 2000 to April 27, 2005. Macedo de la Concha has taught several law courses at the National Autonomous University of Mexico and at the Latin American University, where he chaired the law program. He was he has been assistant director of the legal fiduciary department of the National Bank of Army, Navy, and Air Force, as well as judge and first magistrate of the Supreme Military Court. Currently, he is a military attaché at the Mexican Embassy in Rome. Macedo de la...
There's that Mexican-Rome connection. Mm-hmm. Rome is a part of NATO, which is a part of the beast.
Yep, that's right. Macedo de la Concha is being accused of protecting Joaquin El Chapo Guzman Leora, the most famous living drug trafficker on the planet, still at large during his time at the Procuraduría General de la República under former President Vicente Fox.
Yeah, now former President Vicente Fox, he was a president, I believe it was 2004. It was during his administration that he was the attorney general, this gentleman right here. And he's being accused of protecting this the top drug dealer down there in Latin America or Mexico. Vicente Fox, by the way, is a German. When you check the guy out, he's a German. That's why he had that little mustache on to make him look more Latin. Vicente Fox's real name was Vincent Fox, which was a German whose family had moved to Mexico.
Mm.
Just like you got this guy, the new mayor of New York City. What's his first name? Bill de Blasio. That's not his real name. He's a German. His real name is Wilhelm. Warren Wilhelm, man.
Mm.
He took his mother's name. So he's not really, he's not an Italian. He's a German, man. And then you just read how this guy right here is, he's an attaché between Mexico and Rome. So there goes that connection with Rome. Yep. All right. Yep. Now let's go to the next article.
All right.
So these are not, you know, Nate, you say everything, there's a hoax. I was a hoax and there's going to be a counter article. And these guys are a bunch of nuts. What you said, it's on the video. You're speaking. You said you spoke about the Illuminati.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
This is from NBCNews.com.
NBC News, well-respected, legitimate news agency. Okay, mm-hmm. Go ahead.
Entitled "Microchips Implanted in Mexican Officials, Attorney General Prosecutors Carry Security Pass Under Their Skin." This is dated July 14th, 2004.
Yeah, that's when Vicente Fox was the president in that time.
Mexico City security has reached the subcutaneous level for Mexico's Attorney General and at least 160 people in his office, they have been implanted with microchips that get them access to secure areas of their headquarters. It's a pioneering application of a technology that is widely used in animals but not in humans. Mexico's top federal prosecutors and investigators began receiving chip implants in their arms in November in order to get access to restricted areas inside the Attorney General's headquarters, said Antonio Aceves. General Director of Sol Lusat, the company that distributes the microchips in Mexico. Attorney General Rafael Macedo de la Concha and 160 of his employees were implanted at a cost to taxpayers of $150 for each rice grain sized chip. More are scheduled to get tagged in coming months. And
more are set up to get tagged in the coming months. All right?
Mm-hmm. And key members of the Mexican military, the police, and the office of President Vicente Fox might follow suit, Aceves said. Fox's office immediately... Fox's office did not immediately return a call seeking comment. A spokeswoman for Macedo de la Concha's office said She could not comment on Aceves' statements, citing security concerns. But Macedo himself mentioned the CHIP program to report to reporters Monday, saying he had received an implant in his arm. He said the CHIPs were required to enter a new federal anti-crime information center. It's only for access for security, he said. The CHIPs also could provide more certainty about who accessed sensitive data at any given time. In the past, the biggest security problem for Mexican law enforcement has been corruption by officials themselves.
Yo, that's all we need to read. We got the gist of what it's all about. Okay, let's go back to this. Let's go back to this bean footage.
Yeah, while you're looking for it, because in that production, Nate, when he was talking about the Illuminati,
let's sit on that. You can come back.
He showed a picture of the Bohemian Grove. He showed a picture of the 40-foot stone owl, which is known as
human sacrifice.
Yep, talking about human sacrifice, where you mentioned about children being killed by the Illuminati, which is true. They're being sacrificed, especially at something called the cremation of care. All right, now at one time, the Bohemian Grove, the cremation of care, all of that was a conspiracy theory. Now people are finding out it's a conspiracy fact. All right, because way back in 1981, there was an ABC News segment that was done featuring the Bohemian Grove.
Now a question. What have Herbert Hoover, Art Linkletter, Jack London, and Richard Nixon all had in common? Well, they've all been members of the exclusive all-male Bohemian Club in California, where every year at this time, the elite from around the country get together for 2.5 weeks of fun and games. Steve Shepard has this special assignment report.
More than 2,000 members of San Francisco's exclusive and all-male Bohemian Club have once again descended on Northern California. These men will spend most of the month of July encamped on some 2,700 acres of pristine and privately owned redwood forest. Forest very much like this. The place is called Bohemian Grove, and it's located just 80 miles north of San Francisco. The Grove is the Bohemian Club's summer retreat, and its facilities are hidden beneath lush forest canopy extending south from the banks of Sonoma County's Russian River. For more than a century, the camp has been a place where club members and guests from all across America gather to relax. The retreat is divided into dozens of small camps, the most prominent of which is called Mandalay. Among its members are businessmen like Leonard Firestone and Edgar Kaiser, and political figures like Gerald Ford, Henry Kissinger, William French Smith, and George Shultz. President Reagan, Vice President Bush, and Defense Secretary Weinberger are members of other camps. Richard Nixon is a Bohemian, and so are high-ranking executives of such companies as Eastern Airlines, Standard Oil of Indiana, and Bank of America. For the most part, the men of Bohemian Grove are over 50, highly successful, and, according to many employees, politically conservative.
Well, each year, many of them seem to have a stunt, or try to come up with a stunt. Last year, 1980, the popular button was Free the Fortune 500.
Membership in the Grove is by invitation only and is determined by such factors as social standing, occupation, and personal connections. Privacy is one of the Grove's most cherished virtues. Members may not photograph, record, speak, or write about activities at the retreat. While many public officials are Grove members, the press is a distinctly unwelcome guest.
We're from ABC News.
Well, get back there.
Can we talk to somebody in there?
Get back there.
Anyone willing to navigate a boat up the Russian River can get a glimpse of the northern edge of the compound, but that's about all. Still, there are outsiders who have researched the Grove. Sociology professor William Dumhoff found out enough to write a book on the place.
Well, I think it's a playground for the powerful. It's a place where wealthy men from all over the United States gather for 2 weeks to relive summer camp with this ceremony called the cremation of care that begins the two-week encampment where the body of dull care, symbolizing woes and concerns, is burned on an altar in front of a big owl statue. When that ceremony ends, they all start to cheer and yell and hand each other a beer. And
other regular activities include the production of two plays, one of which involves major sets, orchestral music, and extravagant costumes. The other play appears to be just a bit on the lighter side, at least judging from these old photos. Members also spend time swimming, hiking, relaxing in the sun, and doing a bit of drinking from the Grove's own privately labeled spirits. Like a boys' camp, the Grove has a symbol, in this case a somewhat fierce-looking owl. It also has a patron saint, St. John of Nepomuk, a legitimate 13th-century Bohemian canonized for his sense of honor. What the Grove does not have is any women, not even as employees. Despite its camp-like atmosphere, the Grove does host some serious business.
To the degree that there's anything important happens at the Bohemian Grove, it's political. The important speeches that have been made at the Bohemian Grove have been made, for instance, and the best example, by Richard Nixon. Eisenhower gave a speech there. It was the first time the West Coast establishment really saw him close up.
Discussions at the Grove in the 1930s helped lead to the development of nuclear power and the atomic bomb. It was at the Grove in 1967 that Richard Nixon and Ronald Reagan hashed out differences over their presidential ambitions. Each year, guests like Henry Kissinger or Zbigniew Brzezinski address members on their areas of expertise. Presidential counselor Edwin Meese will be among this year's speakers. And each year, other guests come to the Grove simply to enjoy themselves. This year, CIA Director William Casey is a scheduled guest of John McCone, former CIA director. Baseball Commissioner Bowie Kuhn has been invited as a guest of baseball owner Peter O'Malley. Despite the presence of so many notables, the Grove is not without its small headaches. Anti-nuclear demonstrators gathered near the entrance to the retreat this year to wave signs and chant slogans. The Grove is also facing a suit from the state of California because it refuses to hire women. Still, the Bohemian Grove seems in no danger of passing. Herbert Hoover called it the world's greatest men's party, and there is a list of powerful people waiting to get in on it. Steve Shepard, ABC News, San Francisco.
And they interviewed people at the Bohemian Grove. They interviewed this one white dude. You could tell that dude was a faggot, man. And the Bohemian Grove was being sued because they weren't allowing women in there. It was an all-men retreat. And they were being sued. So now they allow women in certain capacities at the Grove. But the point is, at one time, the Bohemian Grove was a conspiracy theory. Now it's a fact.
Yeah, because somebody leaked it out. Like Joe Valachi leaked to the press about the mafia.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then you had this guy, Nixon. He said that the Bohemian Grove was the most goddamn, this is his quote, the most goddamn faggiest thing I ever saw. All right. That's what Nixon said.
Yeah. So these prophecies, are coming to pass, man. It tells you in the Apocrypha, if anybody want to get it, they can bring it out, be occupied in prophecy. But read a couple of verses above that. All right? Because now these prophecies are taking place. Habakkuk 2, these prophecies are coming to pass. Okay? All right, go ahead and bring it on out.
Okay, this is from the book of Daniel 2, 20 to 20.
You're going
to
find out that the number one group out there is GMS. And we're not saying it to brag or boast.
Okay.
All right? Yeah. And we're at a point now where these other inferior camps, they're trying to see what they can get out of us. Because we have the oil and they don't have the oil. All they're basically doing is all they're doing is being mockingbirds of what they learned from. They got good memories. They learned what they learned from One West.
Done.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah. The Lord said He would feed His elect with knowledge, wisdom, and understanding. That's pursuant to Jeremiah 3:15. So all we're doing is fulfilling prophecy.
Well, hey, there's this commercial of this lawn thing with this Irish guy. And he says, feed your lawn. Right. Feed it.
Right, right.
But he says it with, right, you know,
with passion,
convictions. So you got to, if you want your crops to grow, your grass to grow, you got to feed it.
Yeah.
So we're feeding you. Yeah. All you got to do is take it. You got to digest it.
Yeah,
you can't eat it and spit it out.
Yep.
You got to eat it and digest it, man.
Yep.
And that's how you get your nutrients and your vital nutrients and so forth, your minerals, you know.
Yep.
All the things that you need for the body.
That's
to
right.
Keep the body going. All right.
That's right.
If there's certain foods, if you don't eat, you can go blind, man.
Yeah.
You can get a heart attack.
Done.
You know, there's certain foods and certain combination of foods and herbs, because the scriptures speak about herbs and so forth. Mm-hmm. All right.
Mm-hmm.
That you must take into your body and you must digest it. You don't taste it. You must digest it.
Right.
That's when the food works. That's when it converts into these vital nutrients and minerals and everything good for your body. So, you know, when you want to fill your spirit, you got to go to the scriptures.
That's right.
But you have to have teachers to teach you.
Break it down.
Not all these guys are teachers, man. They might say that they're teachers.
Right.
Just because you say you're a teacher don't mean you're a teacher, man.
Right.
You know?
Right.
We are the real teachers, man. And like I said, I'm not saying it to brag and boast. I'm saying it because it's a fact. It's not a conspiracy, man. It's a fact. Okay?
That's right.
And you see it every day.
That's right.
This is the book of Proverbs 25 and 16.
I'm going to say this. Now, a lot of these guys, I don't know for sure. I could be wrong, but I'm almost positive. Don't be watching on them, young guys. Don't be watching them GMS videos because they'll corrupt you. Well, you know what I tell our guys coming up? I said, watch all them videos, man. You can watch all the Illuminati videos, conspiratory. You can watch Alex Jones. You can watch Nate. You can watch House of David. You can watch you can watch whatever you want. Because through the spirit of Yahweh by Hashem Yahweh Shai, we gave you the knowledge and gave you, and through that you built a filter up to know what's bullshit and what's not bullshit, all right? And we encourage that, okay?
This is Proverbs 25.
By the way, that's not an Illuminati sign. That's a gang sign. That's just my hand going like that, okay?
Proverbs 25:16. Has thou found honey? Eat so much as is sufficient for thee, lest thou be filled therewith and vomited. It is not good.
Well, that's what happened with Mike.
Yep.
Because Mike was so into it that he started writing books, which he said that we made him write these books, which we didn't do that, but let's say we did. So what? If we tell you to do something, you're under us, man. Scripture said, obey them to have the rule over you, man. So, I mean, if we told you to write it, and that's an order. That's an order. That's why you came into the camp, man. I mean, if you had a problem like that, you could have set up your own camp and did it on your own, man. There's people that do that every day. Anyway, he got all this information, and it stopped up his system, so he vomited back out. And who did he run to? He run to the least guy out there, Baloo. Okay? And this guy don't know the scriptures. Show me one video where this guy actually goes into prophecy, man. There's not one. Right now, and I got the video clip, but I don't even have to show it. The producer, you might want to put it up if you want. Down there in Venezuela, there was like almost 20 people dead, if not 20, close to 20. I think it was 13, actually. They're rioting like mad down there. Now, what's happening is they can't get food. They can't get milk. They can't get a flour. They can't get oil. And those are the bare necessities. That's why they're rioting, man. See, you're not doing it up here in the U.S., but you will be doing it when your back is to the wall. Because there's several parents out there with young babies that need to get fed. And they have to get fed themselves. The parents got to feed themselves to stay alive. Now, let's say you go to a supermarket and there's nothing in there. And then you go to the authorities, you call the cops or whatever, and they don't give you no answer. What are you going to do? You're going to go to rioting, man. See, people in the U.S., they think that it's going to be like this way forever, man. The examples that you use are the situation out there in Greece, in Egypt, all right? That's been a hotbed, since 2010, if I'm not mistaken? You got this situation down there in Venezuela. You got this the situation down there in Syria. You got the situation down there in Ukraine, Afghanistan. So I mean, eventually it's going to come right over here.
Yep.
As a matter of fact, you know what? Let's go back to that. Let me see if I can find that.
Man, there's an old saying: a hungry man is an angry man. So, you know, when you're hungry and your belly's rumbling, you know, you're going to lose it.
Yeah, that's it right there. That's it right there.
My name is Daniel Busher. Why is the U.S. government preparing for civil war coming up?
Large sections of the U.S. prepare for armed revolution. Hollow points of the DHS. And that virus on your computer.
The Army now links to systematic covert operations on anyone who criticizes multinationals.
Was played right here. We're here for drone repair.
Declared martial law.
Daddy, what's martial law?
This summer's apocalypse movies tap current fears, notes Elysium director Neil Blomkamp. His new blockbuster shows America as a third world state. He says this isn't science fiction. This is today. This is now. 2 in 3 Americans now say the country is going the wrong direction. Half of them say it could require armed revolution. The New York Times notes America's prepping movement, people preparing for the worst, has now gone mainstream.
Those are mostly white people.
Best-selling author Gerald Celente joins us. Thanks very much for coming on. You write the curtain's coming down on half a century of U.S. dominance. Why do you say that?
Fascism has come to America. I don't say that as an inflammatory statement. I use it as a statement of fact. The merger of state and corporate powers, by definition, is called fascism. And I could back up that fact with 4 simple words. Too big to fail. In capitalism, there is no too big to fail. So it's been a corporate takeover, a military-industrial complex so big that if you just take out one underpinning of a too big to fail, the entire system collapses. They essentially called martial law a state of siege in Boston, magnified.
That was just a dress rehearsal.
In a couple of cities going on at the same time. You're going to see the entire nation break down.
As long as the United States keeps waging war...
The chances of retaliatory attacks grow greater. Hey, there was another drone strike. Another war being fought. There's a Bronx saying that we used to have as I was a kid. Payback's a bitch. The United States can't win a war, whether it's Iraq or Afghanistan, whether it's Libya or whether it was Vietnam. So the people have lost faith in the military aspect of the government, the policing aspects of the government. And so they realize on the economic end that they're on their own. Only the too big to fail are there to be saved.
Yeah, too big to fail banks. People don't realize by law, own your deposits. You know, when they need them, they take them.
If you have your money in your own possession, you don't have your money. Here, this is a fact. When 9/11 happened, I know this personally. I tried to get my money out of certificates of deposit, CDs. And I called up Fleet Bank. They're gone now. They fleeted away. I think Citigroup or one of them, Bank of America, bought them out. And I wanted my money transferred to my local bank. And they said, no, you can't get it. I got shafted by MF Global's scam when John Corzine brought down the company and they stole my money out of my segregated account. So the first thing is the golden rule. If you don't have any gold, you're not going to rule anything. You better have money, and in more than one denomination. And gold and silver is the popular denomination among neo-survivalists. If you were a Greek Cypriot and they closed the banks for what, almost 2 weeks, don't you wish you had some gold and silver to buy what you needed? That was the canary in the mine shaft.
America's canary has actually stopped singing, writes finance site Silver Bear. Your bank savings will be raided in the upcoming crash, quietly admits this new government document,
okay,
which suggests the
back.
Collapse will be much worse than in 2009.
As you can see, you know, that's RT, by the way, which is on, you can go to YouTube, put in RT, and you can watch those videos, which is nothing but news. And if you notice, you know, Esau is preparing, man. They know something's coming down the pike. A lot of these, Jake's out here don't know what the hell's going on, man. And you Israelite groups out there, you other Israelite groups outside the GMS, you don't know what's going on. You're just like going out there and speaking. You don't know why you're speaking. Like you see us speak, and then you go out there speaking. You don't even know what's going on, man. You guys look, you look like you're in a fucking daze, man.
Bewildered.
Excuse my French. You know, I'm trying to cut down on my cursing, man, so I don't offend people no more.
Yeah,
offend. They get so offended, man. Yeah. You know? All right, go ahead.
I got a precept. Oh, I'm sorry.
Bring out your precept.
This is the book of Daniel 2:20-22. It says, Daniel answered and said, blessed be the name of the power forever and ever, for wisdom and might are his, and he changeth the times and the seasons. He removeth kings and setteth up kings. He giveth wisdom unto the wise and knowledge to them that know understanding. He revealeth the deep and secret things. He knoweth what is in the darkness, and the light dwelleth with him. You know, basically, I read that to show that, you know, what we're going into, now it tells you in the book of Psalms, the 64th chapter, that the inward thought of every member of the Illuminati is deep. So when we go into things concerning the Illuminati, the secret societies and all that, that's the Lord giving us that wisdom, Yehovah Shem Yahshua, giving us that wisdom to go into it and explain it and to filter it through the scriptures for the members of the elect, you know. And that's exactly what Daniel told, I believe this was Nebuchadnezzar. He made that statement too. Yeah, I believe it was, Nebuchadnezzar. Yep, he made that statement to Nebuchadnezzar. And it's true, what he said back then, what Daniel said back then to Nebuchadnezzar is true today. All right, there's certain individuals the Most High is revealing deep secrets to, which accounts to prophecy. And that's us here at GMS, man. Them other groups, they ain't going into those. You don't tell me 14th Street moron is going into the deep secrets of the scriptures, the deep secrets of the times. Is he going into that? How about HODC? Are they going into that, Nate? The answer is no, man. The only group that's really going into that, you're looking at that group, is GMS, man. That's why, like Elder Tar always says, that's why Sarnetta came down. Sarnetta, who is part of that black consciousness movement, why did he saw fit to seek out GMS? Because even he knows, well, when it comes to them, that prophecy and stuff, them guys, they be going deep. They go deep into, they know that Bible, you know? That's the point, man.
Ecclesiasticus 39:1. But he that giveth his mind to the law of the Most High and is occupied in the meditation thereof will seek out the wisdom of all the ancient and be occupied in prophecies. You know, so that's basically what, you know, what the Lord said we would be occupied in, prophecies. Okay?
Yeah. Like the footage you just saw, that was straight up prophecy, you know? The footage that you just saw that Elder Tar showed you, that's straight up prophecy.
Yeah, this is Daniel 12:13, right? This is, okay, it says this. But go thou, this is the angel, the messenger talking to Daniel, and he just gave him this prophecy. And he tells him after he gives him the prophecy, he says, but go thou thy way till the end be. Right? It said, go thou thy way till the end be. We're in the end right now. Now, when you jump up to the, I'll start at the third verse. It says, and they that be wise, and let me go to the precept for wise. Hey, you know what the word wise means? Or teachers. Now, I want you to go to that in the blue letter.
That's Daniel 12 and
12. Daniel 12 and 3.
Okay.
And yep. They that be wise.
Right.
So according to this precept here in the margin, it says, it should say, and they that be teachers shall shine as the brightness of the firmament. Hmm. What does it say?
Yeah, the Hebrew word there is shakal. And it says, to be prudent, be circumspect.
Mm. Now the word circumspect, circum meaning to around, and spec means to see. Look all around.
Look around.
You see?
Yeah.
Go ahead.
To be prudent, be circumspect, wisely understand. prosper.
Wisely understand. When you go into these scriptures, you got to understand these scriptures, but you have to wisely understand.
Yeah.
All right?
A technique of doing that too is knowing and understanding words. You got to know your words in the Hebrew, the Greek, and the Latin. All right? Wisely understand, prosper, to look at or upon, have insight. Have insight.
Yeah, insight means that something from outside has to put something in you, in your spirit, and that's the Most High.
Yeah.
Like the way, the reason why we know that the name of the Most High is Yahweh and his son's name is Yahweh Shai. Let's go back to the beginning. Ariad broke it down and taught us to it, but you know it's that by the spirit when he's taught it, but you go and check it out on your own.
Prudent man looking for all to his goings.
So when you go to the Hebrew and you check out certain books, you come to the conclusion that, yes, Ariad was right. He would have to, his name would have to be Yahweh, and his son's name will have to be Yahweh Shai.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah, another example is the chip. It says to have insight. You read Revelation
13. Well, they can't get it because Ariad never taught it. So yeah. They're stuck out there on their own.
Yeah.
Okay?
That's it. Have insight. Have insight. Have comprehension. Oh, to cause to consider. They that be wise will cause you to consider. Give insight. Teach. That's basically it. You know? That a real teacher is supposed to provoke you. You know? There's no other group out there besides GMS that really provokes you into getting into these prophecies, getting into these scriptures. You're supposed to be provoked. You look at these other guys, they put you to sleep, man. They, you know, it's like listening to a soft rock song, you know? You feel all good and shit. You know, there's certain music out there, you listen, it provokes you, you know? That's like us, man. The Lord put that spirit on us. We provoke you. We get into you, you know, through the power of Yahweh Bashim Yahushai.
Now, you can stay with those guys all you want, all right? And anybody that's down with GMS don't like what we're doing, you can go and do your own thing or get within that. We at this point, we don't give a shit.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
We don't care.
Yeah.
Yeah. Now, because the Most High have given us this truth, all right? That's why we're the number one group out there. All right? You know, we got to make a video and get all the different brothers in the camps and have that song, We're Still the One. Yeah. We're still having fun. We're still the one, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
Because we are above, we are light years above HODC, above this guy, Johanna, Nate, all them clowns, man. We're light years above my man, Bubble Eyes, man.
Yeah.
We're light years above you guys, man. Yeah. And that's why you hate us.
Yeah.
Okay? Because the Lord chose to, it's just like the sons of Jacob hated Joseph, right? Mm-hmm. And they wanted to kill him.
Yeah.
They hated him because why? Because he said he had a dream, and basically he said that he going to be over all them. And when he said that, what was the reaction? Hate. Let's kill this guy. Then it was Judah and Reuben that said, look, let's sell him into slavery, which is wicked as hell any damn way.
Right.
And then what happened to him? He rose up over all of them, man. And they had to come bending down to get to him.
Just like the dream showed.
Just like the dream showed, man.
Kind
of. So you guys are fighting and bucking against the spirit, man.
That's right.
You got to stop fighting and bucking. Now, if you're of the elect, you're going to come right to GMS, man.
Yeah.
If you're not of the elect, you're just going to be bugged out, or you might put a gun in your head and pull a trigger.
Yeah.
You might jump off a building, you know?
Yeah.
Or you might just go out there in your pride and go out there speaking and making a goddamn fool out of yourself.
Like Barack.
Barack, you made a fool out of yourself.
Yeah.
They said it before, and it's back all over again. You look like, man, you look like a damn fool, and you got those guys from FOPI. They don't know what's going on.
No, they don't.
The guy's reading there. He don't know what the hell's going on.
Yep.
All he knows is he's got an elder in front of him. Actually, he got an elderly guy that's ready to drop dead, man.
Yeah. Yeah.
And you know what? Hey, the Cornelius thing. Ask him about the Cornelius thing.
Yeah.
They don't say, well, he's an Edomite or he's a Jake. They just ignore you, man. They just ignore you.
That's right.
Because they kind of know now, Nate, That's why y'all kicked us out of the school because of the Cornelius thing. But now Nate got it. Now why did Nate get it? Because it was in the splinter of his mind. Yeah, what if they right? And that's why he went and researched it and got it.
Yeah.
It wasn't that the spirit of the Most High hovered down like a dove and said yes to all them guys were right, Cornelius. Because if that was the case, the Lord right. could have said, oh, and by the way, my name is Yahweh, and it's my son's name is Yahweh
right.
Shai.
Right,
so
right.
don't tell me that the spirit came on you.
Right. Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah. That's good. Yeah,
you
that's
went it. And searched it out for yourself because yep. it was a splinter in the back of your mind. What if them guys are right?
Yeah.
And it took you like anywhere from 15 to 17 years yes, to do it. Now, HODC, they're stuck on stupid, man.
Yeah.
But now they're teaching about Barako. It fits. He covers all boundaries of humanity. He went to Africa and they were eating out of his hand. I ain't seen no videos of him with some peanuts in his hand.
Ridiculous.
And that Hamites eating out of his hand. He went to Arabia. His mother is Jewish. His father is African. He covers all boundaries of humanity.
Barack,
well, that must mean he got some, let me see, got some German up in him, got some Russian up in him,
God.
Some Cantonese up in him,
God.
You know?
Yep.
He a little bit of everybody, man.
Mr. Kaleidoscope.
Yeah, Mr. Kaleidoscope himself in the flesh. You don't realize how stupid you look, man.
This is the book of Isaiah 63 and 10. Yeah, but they rebelled right, and vexed his Holy Spirit.
That's right.
That's what they're doing.
Yeah. Therefore, he was turned to be their enemy, and he fought against them. Then he remembered the days of old, Moses and his people, saying, where is he that brought them up out of the sea with the shepherd of his flock? Where is he that put his Holy Spirit within him, that led them by the right hand of Moses with his glorious arm, dividing the water before them to make him an everlasting name? Ooh. That led them through the deep.
That means their name is still around.
That's right. Their name is still around to this day.
They can't even break down the word ever, you know, which means age. You know, everlasting mean a lasting age. And just had to put that out there.
Come. That led them through the deep as an horse in the wilderness, that they should not stumble. As a beast goeth down into the valley, the spirit of the Lord caused him to rest. So didst thou lead thy people to make thyself a glorious name.
Yeah, and that is the same name that Nate has taken and dragging it in the mud. Which that name is Yahweh, and his son's name is Yahweh Shai. Yep. I got a precept if there's any more.
That was it on that.
Okay. This is the book of Malachi 3:17-18. It says, well, let me start at 16. Then they that fear the Lord spake often one to another, and the Lord hearkened and heard it, and a book of remembrance was written before him for them that feared the Lord. That book of remembrance is the Bible, you know. As a matter of fact, that word record in the Italian is ricordate, which means to remember. So things are recorded so you can remember it. All right, it says, a book of remembrance was written before him for them that feared the Lord and thought upon his name. And they shall be mine, saith the Lord of hosts. By the way, the Lord of hosts means the Lord of armies. All right, when you see that word host there. In that day when I make up my jewels, and I will spare them as a man spareth his own son that serveth him, then shall ye return and discern between the righteous and the wicked, between him that serveth the Most High and him that serveth him not. And you seen that last verse, you seen that now. You brothers out there, certain of you, you're seeing the ones that serve the Most High and the ones that do not serve the Most High. You're seeing that. That prophecy is happening now, even as we speak. You know? You can clearly see that GMS, that we're serving the Most High, Yahweh Bashem Yahshai, mostly because we're going into prophecies, like the scriptures say, to be occupied in prophecies. Them other groups, they're just bullshit, man. Put it plainly, they're just bullshit. Yeah.
Yeah, Nate, this is for you, Nate. Because you're going to be exposed, man, for all that nonsense you're teaching, man.
He's being exposed now.
Exposed right now.
He's being exposed now.
That's right. This is our 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 6. For of this sort are they, I'm sorry, verse 7, ever learning and never able to come to the knowledge of the truth. Now, as Jannes and Jambres withstood Moses, so do these also resist the truth. That's you, Nate. Men of corrupt minds, reprobate concerning the faith, but they shall proceed no further.
I'm sorry, I got to jump in on that reprobate. What does the word reprobate mean? It means a mind void of judgment. Reprobate concerning the faith. The perfect example is the name of the Heavenly Father and His Son. Nate, you are reprobate concerning that. All right? Because you're teaching that the name of the Heavenly Father and His Son is not important. That's what you're teaching, essentially. Then you have...
He's guilty of taking away.
Yeah, and then you took it away.
Add to the book or taken away.
Yeah. Then you have your sight. You have the name of the Heavenly Father. You can't get around it, man.
Well, we got... You're going to see the picture right now.
You can't...
We got it. You put it up years ago.
Yep.
And then you took it down. Yep. But we got it. Okay?
You're supposed to be put to death just on that alone, man. Straight... Real talk, man. You're supposed to be put to death... Yeah, you're supposed to be put to death just on that alone, man, because you got the name of the Heavenly Father.
Guess what? The Most High is going to start putting you guys to death,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, that's right.
You false teachers out there, the Most High is going to start bringing judgment on you, all right?
I think it's a joke.
All man. Of you guys, okay? Because we're dead serious about this, man.
Yeah.
I mean, we have a little fun with it, too. We joke around a little bit, man. Yeah. Hey, but so did Elijah. When he went up against the prophets of Baal, wasn't he telling jokes? Wasn't he snapping
on
him?
Yeah, he was snapping.
All right?
Yeah. Yep. Hey, Yahweh Shai was snapping. When he made that, Elder Tal always brings that out. When he made the comment to John and James, he called them sons of which that moron in Brooklyn, that mumble mouth moron, he don't even understand that. They're always talking about the sons of thunder. It was a joke, man. It was Yahweh Shai was being facetious.
Yeah, you gotta read it. You gotta read it. You guys, on reading is comprehending, man.
That's right.
All right.
That's right. I got a quick precept. Well, I'm sorry, brother. Yeah, go ahead. I'm sorry.
Verse 9. It says, "But they shall proceed no further, for their folly shall be manifest unto all men."
Well, it's being manifested, man.
That's right. That's right.
It's on you, Nate. On you, Barack.
That's right.
On you, HODC. On you, Johanna.
Yeah.
Johanna.
Hey, you guys get mad. I'm sorry. You guys get mad when I say yep. 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 Hey, if I had something that I don't agree with, I'm going to say nope. Nope. Hey, you know? That's right. Just had to throw that in. Good. Yep.
It says, "But they shall proceed no further, for their folly shall be manifest unto all men, as theirs also was."
Yeah, like with the, this video is showing your folly, Nate. Them stupid, dumb-ass comments that you make sitting on that, like you're the king of Siam, you know, sitting up there making those comments. Like the conspiracy comment. Man, there's a video called The Capitalist Conspiracy by this guy, G. Edward Griffin. He goes all into conspiracy. Yep. He makes statements like the world, since the beginning of time, the world has been burdened with conspiracies. But you're going to sit up there. Anybody who believes in a conspiracy generally is a nut. He's a nut. But then you emphasize the word nut. You're the nut, man.
But then you're one of the nuts.
Yeah.
Because we got you on a video. We showed it to you. You're going to see it again.
Yep.
Where you spoke about the Illuminati.
Yep.
Isn't that a conspiracy theory, Nate? Huh?
Yeah.
Huh, Nate?
And whoever produced your videos, he put a picture of the Isle of Molech. Yep. All right? Which, the Isle of Molech, that's in the scriptures. Molech is in the scriptures. All right? The wicked children of Israel, they sacrificed their children unto Molech. Go ahead, bro.
It says, verse 12, "Yea, and all that will live godly in Yahweh Shai shall suffer persecution. But evil men and seducers shall wax worse and worse, deceiving and being deceived.
Sure.
But continue thou in the things which thou hast learnt and has been assured of, knowing of whom thou hast learned them, and that from a child thou hast known the holy scriptures, which are able to make thee wise unto salvation through faith which is in Yahweh Shai." It says, "All scripture is given by inspiration of the Most High, and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness." And part of the correction is not always pretty. You know, sometimes you get on somebody and it's not.
It's never pretty when you correct somebody, you rebuke somebody. It's generally not pretty, you know. Yeah. And that's not, this is not us doing it, man, out of pride or malice. This is the Most High speaking through us, man. That's right. I got the scripture here. Matter of fact, I got two scriptures. I'm going to read this one, 1 Timothy 4:1. Now the Spirit speaketh expressly that in the latter times, we're in the latter times, some shall depart from the faith. Well, Nate is always talking about how you have to have a plan and you had to do this and you got to have this stocked up. And Yahweh Sab is right along with him. Yeah, bears, they hibernate. Yeah, what other animals hibernate? They put food for the wintertime. Well, look, we got faith, my man, all right? And what you call us the faith-based Israelites. Well, thank you. I take that as a compliment, all right? It says that in the latter times some shall depart from the faith. And that's what you did, Nate. You departed from the faith, all right? That's why you became a cop and a detective to get those benefits and those goodies and that nice pay, okay? Giving heed to seducing spirits and doctrines of devils. Excuse me. Giving heed to seducing spirits and doctrines of devils. Speaking lies and hypocrisy, having their conscience seared with a hot iron. Now, you said on your history, going into the history, you said there, Tahar, back when he was in his right mind, he was right about the Cornelius thing, but he was teaching that you can rape 9-year-old girls. I never taught that, man. I never taught that. Matter of fact, I never taught about raping any damn body, man. Okay? We didn't teach that to the congregation, man. So we caught your motherfucking ass in a lie, man. You see?
Yeah. Hey, in the first
that's called bearing false witness, man.
That's right. Hey, in the first verse, it says doctrines of devils. Good example of that is when you brought out about the marriage thing. You said that you got to get a paper, and then you held it up, I believe. You know, of the so-called marriage certificate.
All them women that David had, he didn't get no paper, man.
Yeah.
He could have had it on record. You can have it on record, but if you don't have it on record, and you pop a woman, everybody knows that you're... Even in Esau society, prior to 1938, you had a thing called... that's when the Constitution was... basically, I go back to the case law of Erie Railroad versus Tompkins, which overturns... I think it's Swift versus Tyson. Mm. When during the period of 1938, I think the final decision was in 38. This guy, Tompkins had sued Erie Railroad, and he had won like $30,000. And then Erie Railroad had turned around and appealed it, and it eventually went to the it was a certiorari to the look that word up, certiorari to the Supreme Court, and basically they overturned it. And basically in that case law was this, that a state law supersedes the Constitution. Which meant what? The Constitution is done away with, man. That's why in Texas, state law says you can have you have open carry. New York, you can't do that. But don't we have a common Constitution? Isn't there a what is it called? The not the sister state clause, the supremacy clause of the Constitution.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Where basically the Constitution is the supreme law of the land, going back to Marbury versus Madison, and mm-hmm. It clearly states the Constitution is the supreme law of the land. But as of 1938, that's not so.
Right.
It's a state constitution, a state law that is complete, that has law over that land. Okay? So that's what happened, man. Mm-hmm. You see? That's just a little tidbit of information on how the Constitution works.
Right. Yeah, well, like I said, going back to the doctrine of devils, you brought that out about the marriage certificate. And like I said, I believe you held up that.
I'm sorry. That right. So that leads to the marriage thing. Mm-hmm. Like I said, you have at one point prior to 1938, prior to that case law, Erie Railroad versus Tompkin. Prior to that, all the states recognized common law. Like if you with a woman, you don't got no papers on a woman, and everybody knows that you and that woman been are item, as they would say. Mm-hmm. when you die, the woman could get your body, and if you have money in the bank, it'll go to you because that was your common law wife.
Right.
And some states say after 7 years, that's your common law wife. That was done away with in 1938.
Yeah.
Okay? So really, they did away with the Constitution. And they really did away with common law. When you coming back talking about you have to have papers, even Esau don't believe in that, man.
That's right.
Now, can you get papers? Yes, you can. Can you put it on record? Yes, you can.
That's right.
But do you have to put it on record? No. If you're dealing with a woman and y'all are item, everybody's going to look at you as husband and wife, man.
Yeah. Yeah, so it's you know, you're pushing that. That's a doctrine of devils, because that's not back to the organic law, which is the Bible. You know? That's the so-called white man's bullshit. And like we said, you're nothing but an officer of the court anyway. You was a detective. You was a cop. You know?
Still, if you retire as an officer, you still have your gun. They basically say the only one that can have a gun is a police officer in that jurisdiction. But wait a minute, you're a retired man. That means if you see a crime taking place, you can look the other way because you're retired. You can choose to do something as a retired cop.
Yeah.
But you can't go out writing tickets because you're retired, man.
Yeah.
All right? Like this one guy that retired, he was a cop. And I kind of made a U-turn. I said, oh, I'm sorry. He said, I don't care. You can U-turn all you want. I don't give a damn. I ain't a cop no more. I'm retired. Right. You wasn't going to get a ticket from me anyway because right. I know you, but you damn sure ain't going to get a ticket now because I'm retired, you know? Right. But anyway, let me read this here scripture right quick. This is 2 Timothy. I read 1 Timothy 4. Now I'm going to 2 Timothy 4. It says this. 2 Timothy 4:1. I charge thee therefore before the Most High and the Lord Yahweh Shai, who shall judge the quick and the dead at his appearing. And he is coming back soon. And his kingdom, and he's bringing back a kingdom, all right? It says, this is a charge now. Wait a minute. This is Paul speaking, right? Letter to Timothy. And this is for all of you that are part of this thing, okay? It says, I charge thee, second verse, preach the word, be instant in season, out of season, reprove. Look up the word reprove, brother.
Come.
Rebuke, look up the word rebuke. Exhort, look up the word exhort. With all long-suffering and doctrine, look up the word long-suffering, look up the word doctrine, mm-hmm. All right?
Mm-hmm.
Three. For the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine. When you teach that Cornelius is an Edomite, that's not sound doctrine, man. When you teach the name of the Lord is Christ and the Heavenly Father's name is God or the Most High, that ain't his name, man. Those are titles, all right? When you teach Barack Obama is the Antichrist, you're going off. When you teach the mark of the beast is talking about the nations or an embargo or whatever the hell you talking about, you're going off, all right?
And it's not sound doctrine.
It's not sound doctrine. So, Nate, you're not teaching sound doctrine. All right, for the time will come when they will not endorse sound doctrine. Like I ran into two of the men that's under you, and I tried to give them sound doctrine, and they didn't endure it. They didn't accept it, man. Because you brainwashed them. It says, sound doctrine, but after their own lust shall they heap to themselves teachers having itching ears. Right. Four, and they shall turn away their ear from the truth. We have the truth, and shall be turned unto fables. Like, for example, this guy, Baloo, is getting on us about the Feast of Weeks, and I counted it this morning on the calendar. And it's right in order, man. See, you don't understand how to read calendars and the new moon. I counted it three times. I went through it three times, man. And then from the first day, you count seven Sabbaths. It's 49 days plus one makes it 50. That's why in the New Testament, it was called a Pentecost, all right? Because that first day, you count it the next day after, that's when it starts. And we're going to do that when we get back into the kingdom, all right? When we was back in our kingdom in the ancient world, after the Passover, when they went back home, they started planting seeds and all that, man. Yeah, like I said, I went through it just for my own self, okay? Just to see if I'm going off. I went through the thing and it was right on point. That last day is the so-called 50th day. That's why they call it the Pentecost. The word Pentecost is from the Greek meaning 50, all right? Meaning the 50 days.
Right, and then when Yahawashi came, after Yahawashi was crucified and he came back, he was resurrected back to life and he came around the disciples, it said that he was with the disciples, this was after the Passover, he was with the disciples 40 days.
Pentecost came, it didn't say it exactly, so that was another 10 days, all
right? That's right, so it was around the same, it was around, the 50th day started around the ending of the Passover. And that proved it because when Yahawashi came back and was with them 40 days, he said, look, tarry here in Jerusalem till you be endowed with power from on high.
And it happened 10 days. It doesn't have to say that. Right. But if you know the scriptures, you know it took another 10 days. Right. All right?
That's right. You know, so that shows you that we're keeping it correct. You know, for those of you scoffers out there.
Yeah, I was told to look up some words. Yeah, the first word is reprove. The Greek word.
Strong's G, 1651. Elegho. Elegho.
It says to convict, refute, confute. By conviction, to bring to light, to expose.
What's the key word?
Reprove.
Okay.
So. Yeah, to expose.
When you bring up them videos, when you said that the name of the Most High is Christ, or the Son's name is Christ, and the name of the Father is the Most High, and then there was a video came out years back when you was with Bunyamian, that and you were cursing people out. You're simple. If you can't get that, something wrong with you. You know, uh-huh. You were wearing that Joker. You know, when you play cards and you got the jokers, sometimes you can say jokers a while, right? Yep. Or you can cast the jokers out. When I used to play, we just gonna cast the jokers out.
Jack too.
Jack of
fools.
Yeah, that's right. That's right.
Jack of fools.
Yep.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Okay. Oh, I'm sorry. To bring to light, to expose.
And that was brought to light, my man. The thing about conspiracy theorists is usually a nut. And then right after that, in the clip, you're saying it. I didn't edit it that way. I didn't make your mouth say that. You said that, man, in one of your classes, bro. And then you said that's talking about the Illuminati. They kill babies and all that, man. So now when that comes up, you guys are going to be on the comment board. You mean to tell me a grown-ass man actually did this? Yes, a grown-ass man actually did this. It's called exposing somebody.
Yeah, that's right. That's right.
Grown people expose other people.
Yeah, especially if they're phony, you know?
Now, let's say you caught us on something. We said one thing and changed it up. We'll come back and say, well, yeah, we was off on that.
Yeah.
Or we went into it. We would acknowledge it, man.
Yeah.
Okay, we ain't gonna do like HODC 12. You ask them about Cornelius, and they're just gonna ignore it, man. You know.
Yeah.
Then you got guys, Tahar, you going around talking about people because they don't go out on the highways or the byways. But what about Yohanabar? Yohanabar is a helper, right?
That's right.
Give me a video where he 3 years ago where he actually went out. He was a leader of a camp and had men around him. How you gonna get around that? Now, Baloo is a so-called acknowledged leader of a camp, right?
Yeah, he's supposed to be a teacher.
A leader?
Yep.
He's out there speaking to guys around him, reading for him. He made it obvious he's a leader.
Right.
So all of a sudden, now he don't go out no more?
Right.
Now, if he says, I was just a helper, then don't play like you a leader, man.
Yeah, then.
Okay? Make up your mind, man.
Make up your mind.
And like I give an example. I get on Zabak, but guess what? Zabak be going out there, man.
Right.
Zabak goes out there strong, bro.
Yeah.
Now, he's going off because of the adultery thing, and he's not breaking down all the scriptures, but he does go out there.
Yeah. Even when it's cold, right?
He'd be out there when it's cold, man.
Like Baloo.
Even Johanna's men be going out there. Or they go out in the winter, the summer.
Yeah.
All right?
Yeah.
They don't have the full doctrine, man. Hey, we'll give credit. If you deserve credit, we're going to give you credit, man. Okay? When Johanna's, the man, the general under him, Tsarnaev, went up against Polite, we were rooting for him. You know, even though we met Polite, Brother Polite and all that, we were rooting for him. And Polite knew when he came down there and he was dealing with us, he knew that we was with this guy. But why? Because he's an Israelite, man.
That's right.
Now, we might be so-called enemies. We're really not even enemies, man. We get on each other and shit. If I ran into any of them brothers, man, hey, Shalom, what's up, man? You want to go into the scriptures? Now, they might want to shoot me or something because I didn't said a whole lot, you know? Yeah, I didn't ruffle some feathers, man, but I ain't going to do nothing to them, man. And we see Johanna Bar with a flat tire. There we go. Get that. We ain't going to do that, man. And we might even help Johanna, man. Look, let's help Johanna fix it. Because me and Johanna got history, man. And I can talk to him, but I'm going to tell him, I say, look, man, you got to stop lying, bro. You got to stop that lying, man. You know, you're going off on that, and you said this, and you said Mo died 6 months later.
Yeah.
Come on, man. Yeah. Come on. If you claim to be a man of the Lord, you better get your act together, man.
That's heaping coals of fire on his head.
And that's heaping coals of fire on his head if he doesn't repent.
That's right.
See, now the door is open for you to repent, man.
Yeah.
All right?
Yeah. Was that in the book of Jude? That does not bring a railing accusation, but said the Lord rebuketh thee. Yeah.
Yeah, because you got the black consciousness movement. Well, where's the tomb of Moses? When you read the Jude, when you go to the history, the angel came down and took Moses' body.
Mm-hmm.
You can't find it, man.
Right.
When you go to the Apocrypha, the Ark of the Covenant, it was hidden. You can't find it, man.
That's right.
Esau search out everything, right? He haven't found that, the Ark of the Covenant, man, because if he did, he would showed it off.
Or Moses' body. His skeleton.
Or Moses' body.
His skeleton, yep.
Or Abraham, you know?
Yeah.
Or the Lord himself. You couldn't find the Lord. They said that there was the trial of Turin, which was bullshit, which is a damn hoax.
Right.
And when the Lord left, he left with them clothes, man.
Right.
Am I right about that? Did he leave with his clothes? He was wound up with them clothes, man, you know? So you ain't going to find the Lord in a mummified Yahweh Shai. He ain't going to find a mummified Moses.
Yeah.
And basically, you come into this because of faith, not because you found evidence of something.
Gone.
See, that's why you people in the black consciousness movement, you're lost because you're, well, I got evidence and I got this book. And then most of the books, like Shaka Amos, right?
Mm-hmm.
Most of them books that you read are written by so-called Jews, man.
So-called white
people. And they're the white people, man.
Right.
How do you know how true it? Well, that is a coffin text. And
right.
Who translated it into the coffin text but the so-called white man?
Right.
But you call a white man a devil, right?
Right.
How do you know if the white man is not lying to you?
Yeah, the library in Alexandria was built by the so-called white man. So it
during
starts
the time
from there.
Of the Alexander's rulership, he had four generals. The one general that came up would raise up with him. They were young. They were all young. They were kids, okay?
Right.
When I say kids, in their 20s, all right? Because when Alexander started taking down the dark nations, he was 20 years old.
20 years old, yep.
He was 20 years old. That's a kid, man, you know? And he, for 12 years, mm-hmm. he took down them dark nations, man. And then when he got sick and died, now why did he get sick and die? The Most High plagued him
yep.
to die because he fulfilled his lot.
His lot, yeah.
Okay? Yeah. Even though he's a devil, he fulfilled his lot.
Okay.
His father, Philip, wanted to be that. They knew about the prophecy, and he wanted to be that guy, and it was his son. And he hated his son for it, man.
Right.
He hated the fact that his son was that guy, and he wanted to be the great conqueror. Even though he conquered, mm-hmm. but not like his son. The top men that came up with him as young men, the kingdom was split up among them. Now, it was Ptolemy, the line of the Ptolemaic dynasty that took Egypt, man. And you know what they were doing? They were dressing up in the Egyptian god.
Yep.
They had the Egyptian thing, and they built things in certain, like when you go, and when you send out archaeologists to dig up certain things in Egypt, you'll see what's called white pharaohs. And they'll say, see, the pharaohs are really white. This is the proof. No, those were the descendants of the Ptolemaic dynasty, man.
God.
Like Cleopatra. Wasn't she the daughter of one of the Ptolemies?
Yeah.
She was one of the and she married. Was she the daughter of him Seleucus?
I think she was Ptolemy the 12th, right?
But I know that she married one of the Seleucus because there was a ongoing war between the Seleucid dynasty and the Ptolemaic dynasty, which is all recorded in Daniel 11, which none of you guys, not HODC 12, not a Comfy, not Johanna, not eye. Nate, none of you guys can break that down.
Yeah, Bubble Eye.
Not Bubble Eye, not none of you guys. All right?
That's right.
You might be able to get little things, but that whole Daniel 11 chapter, which Ariad never went into, that whole Daniel 11 chapter is talking about the ongoing war between the Ptolemaic dynasty and the Seleucid dynasty.
Con.
Okay, Ptolemy the 12th was the father, okay? And why don't you know it? Why haven't you taught a class on it? Because Ariad didn't teach you that, man. Like right. I said, you guys you guys memorize a lot of stuff and you're regurgitating it back out. That's why a lot of you guys are teaching that Cornelius is an Edomite, because that's what you were taught at the old school. Okay, that's why we got kicked out of school. And Barack, you said, Tahar, you mad because you got mistreated. Yes, you're right. I did get mistreated. You know how I got mistreated? Not treated right? Because when I bring out the truth, you guys said, y'all got to get out of here.
Yeah.
Because you couldn't receive it.
Didn't even want to pray with us.
Right. They didn't even want to pray with us, man. You know?
Yeah.
And it was Rahab that said that, which fell out. He's an adulterer any goddamn way. Mm-hmm. He dealt with Barack's woman. Where everybody knew that was Barack's woman, all of a sudden he wound up with this woman talking about, I didn't know her, Barack was having sex. You mean to tell me you didn't ask a woman or you didn't ask Barack? Hey, if I see Gabar walking hand in hand with a woman for a couple of months, even a day, if I look at that woman like I don't get with her, I'm going to ask you, are you actually dealing with her? Are you popping her?
Yep.
And if you said no, I'll still leave it alone because you potentially going to pop her. So that was complete wickedness, man.
Right.
Complete wickedness, man. And Mike, you made a statement, we don't need to be getting on Israel. They had enough. Man, when you said that, man, the smoke came out of my ears, man. And my nose, man. Man, I'm thinking about all the homos among you Negroes, you Negro men, all the lesbians, all the abortions that black women are going to the hospital and getting their fetuses aborted, man, and you Latin tribes, all the schemes that you niggas, all you niggas selling drugs out there, man, and all you niggas out there, you selling cars and lying to people, you schemers, you lot of you women deal with you a lot of you women, you got five different men. And you only see one man on a Friday. That's your Friday nigga, man. You know? And there's one chick I was dealing with. Well, you just come around on Friday. Don't call me. I said, yeah, because you got a Tuesday nigga, a Wednesday nigga, a Thursday nigga. You know? I said, you a nasty ass hoe, man.
Yeah, like that song, Saturday Love.
That's right. Yep.
You would be my Saturday Love.
Well, actually, when you go into that song, it was about adultery. It was about adultery.
Yeah, that's why it was so popular.
Yep, that's right. Well, everybody loves adultery themes. Jake loves a theme with OPP. That was like a top. That was on top for a long time, man.
Hell yeah.
Because Jake was into that, man.
Me and Mrs. Jones.
Yeah, me and Miss, right? Other people's property, okay?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, rebuke. Still looking up these words. Rebuke, the Greek word.
Strong's G, 2008.
Okay, let me correct that. The linen clothes was in a sepulcher, all right? So I was wrong on that, okay? That was called a misspoken. But guess what? He went back and checked it. Just like this morning I got up and I checked the Pentecost, and it was correct. We check things, man.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
If we go off, or if we miss, go and correct it, man.
We correct ourselves.
And a lot of you guys, You don't want to even address the thing on the Cornelius thing like a priest Dunya Allah. You asked that many a times a couple of years back, man, and you ignore it, brother. You ignore it, man.
Yep.
You can't ignore that, man. That's part of the scriptures, man. Now, you don't want to admit it because Nate admitted it, man, because it was in the back of his mind.
That's right. Yeah, well, we always say nobody gets more on GMS than we do. We get on ourselves, you know? So, anyway, the Greek word rebuke.
Epitimao.
And it says to show honor, to honor, to adjudge, to tax with fault, to admonish or charge sharply. And when Elder Tar read about when Paul said to Timothy, I charge thee, I had looked up the word charge, and it means to an extreme request. Like when you charge somebody. You know, back in the ancient world, when somebody was brought on charges, that was a very important thing, man.
Yeah, another word for charge, I charge you, is you're commanded. You're commanded. To go out there and speak. You go out there in season and out of season, okay?
That's right.
And so you know, that's a cut to you guys that's not going out there, man.
Yeah. The next word is exhort, is the Greek.
Strong's G, 3870. Parakaleo. Parakaleo.
It says to call to one side, call for summon, to admonish, exhort, to encourage, strengthen. All right, so the next word is long-suffering. The Greek word.
Strong's G, 3115, makrathumia, makrathumia.
And it says patience. Does the word patience mean to suffer? Endurance. Now, the scriptures say endure sound doctrine means you got to be hard to deal with the truth. Because when you look that word up, endure, it comes from the word durable, which means hard. When something is durable, that means it's hard. It can take punishment. You know, it's like a speed bag or a boxing Everlast punching bag. That's durable. You can hit the shit out of it. It just keeps coming back for more. You know, patience, endurance, constancy. Now that's a lot of them different groups. They're guilty of that. They're not consistent. They're not consistent. Constancy.
Yeah, an example of that is HODC came out. We started putting up videos on YouTube in July of 07, and I believe they started putting up videos sometimes in 08. It could have been the end of 07 or the beginning of 08, but I remember when they came on the scene, and the videos that they put up, there were no videos of them speaking out there on the highways and the byways.
Yeah.
And that was for a good couple of years. And then, you know, at one time it popped up, they was out there on the streets. And I don't know if they're going to come. Well, knowing them, they're going to deny it. No, we was always out in the streets and all that. That's bullshit,
which
man.
Which is a damn lie.
Look, one thing GMS does, we watch all your videos, man. We check out all your videos, just like you check out our videos. We check out Nate's videos, your Honda videos. We check out all of them, and they check out our videos, man, to see what new thing has come up, man. We check out all you guys. So you're going to tell me that I'm lying? I ain't lying, man.
That's right.
There was a point for a couple of years. The first, I think you started going out there maybe mid-2010, something like that. You start, but for the first couple of years, all your videos was in a dark room. What I believe was Menorah was in the background, man.
Yeah, boring as hell too.
Yep,
those videos were boring as hell too.
And then like, if you go to their videos right now, they put up a new site going back 3 months. There's no hits on it, man. You go back 3 months, you might have 22 hits, 13 hits.
Yeah, that's why you want to come together with everybody.
And then you're going to say, let's come together. Yeah. Well, and our response is, we're not going to come together with y'all, man. Because a lot of y'all are not of the elect, all right?
And Yakanan, he got you good, the latest video he did. Now, on one hand, Barack, you're saying that that this guy, Gehenna, was guilty of trying to murder Mo. There was this murder conspiracy. Now, towards the end of the video, you said that the door is open for Yohanna. So that means
why would you want to get with a guy that you know with a murderer?
Yeah.
Or why would you ask to get with Comfy? Comfy is teaching that there's a guy out there's a hell, and there's a guy down there that punch you in the face, and there's no scriptures on that.
Yeah.
Then Mary and Joseph never had sex. Come on, man. If you did that, if you bring all these people together, you know, first of all, if I'm at the meeting, if I do go at the meeting, you're gonna hear me out from the top of my lungs, man. And that finger's gonna be waving in your, they're gonna be fights breaking out and all that, man. Yeah,
that's right.
Chairs are gonna be thrown.
Yeah, that's right.
People are gonna start getting up and leave. It'll be chaotic, man.
That's right.
Okay?
That's right.
It'll be chaotic.
Yeah.
Could you imagine Nate being up in there and Comfy being up in there and us being up in there and them being up there? Could you imagine it? Because we seen the bullshit, man.
That's right.
There'll be all kind of accusations going back and forth, man.
That's right. Yeah. The council. Yeah, I was just thinking about that. The council all those years back. You guys showed yourself to be demons. That's why Elder Tar made that statement. This is a high-tech lynching, and all you motherfuckers were laughing, man. Yep. You know?
Well, them guys didn't know. They see Barack, Benjamin, and all of them got, all of a sudden, they found their boldness and shit. Back then, they were quiet as a church mouses, man.
Yeah.
They ain't have a peep about nothing. They ain't even said nothing, man. They just sat back. All right?
Yeah, you were never innovators, Ben. You was never an innovator, man. You wasn't ideas man or get things started.
Well, that's an act. What they're doing now is an act, man. It's a that's fucking all, act. All they're doing is an act, man.
You act like we don't know
you guys.
And
there was a thing. There was a time where they had Shabazz's woman was taken away by the council and given to a lawyer. Did Benjamin? Did you stand up with a toothpick in your mouth and say, "Look, that's wrong"? Now, if you come back and say, "Well, did you do it?" Yes, I did. I said that that's adultery, man. I pulled Lahab. I said, "Lahab, that's adultery." All right?
Yeah.
There was a point where Lahab had a party set up, and he was giving out tickets to people. And then I guess he wasn't selling enough tickets, so he had a meeting, and he said, "We're going to allow Edomites to come to the party, man." And Mashah was there. Shaw was there. Yeshaya was there. Ariah was there. Gazak, I believe he was there. And you guys had to be there. Maybe you say, "Well, I wasn't there." But you know what happened? I looked around when he said that, and there was not a peep from nobody, man. I looked around at Shaw. I looked at Yeshaya. I said, "Yeshaya ain't saying nothing." I looked at Mo, and Mo was going like this, drinking his coffee or whatever. And I looked at Ariah, and Ariah had a mean look on his face, man. And I said, "Ariah, you," I was sitting right next to Ariah. I said, "Ariah, are you with this bullshit?" He said, "Hell no." Mm. And then me and Ariah raised, he said, "No, ain't no crackers coming to no party, man."
Yeah.
And then when me and Ariah said that, that's right. Yeah, we ain't going to have no Edomites up in there. Was you there, man? Did you go to Lahab's parties where they used to ask everybody for $100 to get the place and then have you go to the parties and charge you to go into the parties and charge you for beer and food? And then that was back in the late 80s, early 89 or whatever. I don't know the exact year. And then they realized they would sell Heineken for like $2. Then they realized they wanted more money and the price would go up from $2 to $5, man. And I remember I didn't go to that party because I said I ain't going to that fucking party, man, because those guys are demons, man, you know? And here you are drinking and shit, and then you go to get another Heineken, and then it's $5. Here you gave them $100 to get the place.
Yeah.
Here you paying to get in, and they're going to charge you $5 for a Heineken. 2 hours ago, it was $2, man, because it was all about money, man.
Not even the so-called Jew would do that shit.
That's right, man.
And he's the devil.
But nobody had nothing negative to say about Lahab.
Yeah.
Nobody ever had nothing to say about that guy, man. But here you guys, you clowns, now all of a sudden you found your voice. Now all of a sudden you bold. Was you bold back then?
Nope. Yeah, we were brought to council, but we were charged, beginning with Elder Tar, we were charged with saying that Lahab is the black demon.
Well, you know what? We told the truth.
And we were.
And that's right why there. Lahab didn't get mad, because he knew. He said, "Yeah, they found out."
Yep.
Them cats found out.
Yep. Were you there, Ben, with your toothpick in your mouth? And we didn't back down. It was Elder Tar.
Ben, you come on, stop faking, man.
Yeah, stop faking.
Stop faking like you some tough guy, man. You ain't no tough guy, man. When you came up to the school up there, up in Connecticut, you had the toothpick in your mouth, walking like a fake gangster, man.
God,
Come on, man.
Well, gangster rap was big back then. Hey, well.
So wait a minute. Is that Ben?
Yeah.
I said, Ben, that wasn't Ben last week. Where you get that toothpick from?
He's a good actor. Hey, it was Elder Tar, myself, and Elder Ricard. And this guy, Robert Jones, we always talk about him. He got up in the council. He did that temptation spin. And he said, Lahab, you want to hear this? This brother and this brother and this brother, they call Lahab the black demon. They said the sentence isn't right.
Oh, and I got a video, and I can bring it up on this guy, Yashawan. You know how he came back out of the tar pits, and he had made this video, and I got it recorded, where he said, you know, they had the some central commands, and I really wasn't into that central command.
Oh, man.
Making all that money. See? I said, I wouldn't know. I used to like to go out speaking. Well, see? Yashawan, why didn't you say something, man?
Yeah.
They had me going to all these meetings. I couldn't go to the camp no more. It was all about money with these guys.
I never liked you, man. Yashawan, I never liked your motherfucking ass. You bought, is that the case? So that's why you bought 3 pairs of $800 boots, right? Because you hated the central command so much, right? You was getting paid, nigga, and you was loving it, man. And the proof is you bought $800 boots. $800 boots. $800 can pay... 3 pairs of them, which is $2,400. $800 back then could have paid your month's rent, man. You've just plopped that down.
$800 back then could have paid maybe 2 or 3 months' rent, man.
Well, there you go. That even makes my point even more. But you just plopped down $2,400 for boots. And then meanwhile, there were brothers that was homeless. You know how I know? I was one of them. And I asked you, Yashawan, I said, hey, I asked you if I could sleep Where you put those oils, where the oils were.
Yeah, you told that story, but the thing is,
yeah,
when you said that, he said no. But when somebody had broke into thing, then they ordered you to stay up there.
Yeah, look at that.
So you guys are a bunch of niggas, man.
Then you made fun of me. You said, what camp are you in? I said, I'm in Tahar's camp. Well, look at you. You look so tacky. Why are you so tacky? That's what you said. I can hear it in my head now. All right? That's what you said, man. You said, you're so tacky. Now, where are you at now, Yashawan? Where are you?
Well, he's still tacky living off now? He's living off of that money that he stole, man.
Yeah.
And that house. And getting ready to get that the house. And then, you know what's funny? I got to say this. I had a dream about this guy. And I actually ran into him, man. And we kind of gave each other a dirty look. And then we started talking, man. And then we were, like, cool with each other, man. And then he said, yeah, let me let you, I'm still with my wife. And she kind of gave me a dirty look. I gave her a dirty, and then we were cool with each other, man. So, you know what that's showing me, man? That all this strife, when the kingdom comes, we're going to come back together any damn way, man.
Kingdom, yeah.
We're going to come back together any damn way, all
right? Yeah, that's right.
So even if you don't make it on this go around, you're going to come back on the next go around, man.
Yeah.
You're going to come back anyway. And you guys should just be happy that you're not Edomites, man. That's all. Just be happy that you're not Edomites.
This is Acts chapter 20, verse 28.
We wish you were.
It says, take heed therefore unto yourselves and to all the flock over the which the Holy Spirit hath made you overseers, to feed the church of the Most High, which he hath purchased with his own blood. For I know this, that after my departing shall grievous wolves enter in among you, not sparing the flock. Also of your own selves shall men arise, speaking perverse things to draw away disciples after them. You know, and that's what happened. You know, because when that whole situation was going down with the central command, when they finally left, they were going around trying to see how many brothers they could take with them. You know, spreading that bullshit doctrine that they were spreading. The virgin birth and other such doctrines that they had back then.
Yeah, and where was Ben's voice over Comfy? All that shit that for years, man, all that shit Comfy was talking. Where was your voice then, Ben? All of a sudden now you this big speaker. You.
Oh, and then to show you that you guys are lacking faith, you said in your video, the hot seat, the first one that you made, that we didn't follow Mashah because he was King David. That was just a name. No. Mashah was well known that he was King David. Okay? And if you've been to school that long, you knew that. And there was guys that got kicked out for saying, I don't see that. I don't see it, man. So now you went back on your oath, man.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
You guys, hey, brother, you guys are being exposed right now, man. Okay? When you made that first hot seat, it was really for Johanna. You really wasn't getting on me, but I had to come back in there and cut you guys, man. That's why you had to come back and make one on me, talking about you got to correct talk. You ain't, there's nothing you can correct me on, brother.
That's right.
You ain't got nothing on me, man.
That's right.
You ain't got nothing on me, all right? Everything I did was according to the scriptures, bro.
Yeah, now, speaking of that oath, I happened to be there that same day where they made everybody take an oath because you had the two. I don't remember if he probably was there. Cause you know you had the main classroom and then you had the room across the hall. I was in the room across the hall. They had the speaker, the loudspeaker coming from the one room to the other, and they made everybody in there take an oath that day that Mashiach is King David, and if you go back on that oath, the Most High is gonna kill you, something to that effect. So I was there. I took the oath. I was there.
Yeah, but then Ariah came back. It's a cut on Ariah when the split came. Ariah said, look to her, if you go with Mo, the Most High gonna kill you. Well, wait a minute, ain't he the king?
That's right, yeah.
And then I told Ariah, and you was right there as my witness, Gabar, and I said, well, I guess the Most High gonna kill me. Yeah. And that was what, back in 1996, man?
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
You got something?
No, I don't.
So basically, you know, all this stuff going around. See, you guys, you guys thought because these people out here, they don't know what's going on. The people that's watching now, they don't know what was going on back then, you know. But the Lord had, you know, Elder Tahar, Elder Gabar, Elder Rakai, and some of us later on, you know, that still remember some of the stuff that was going on back then, the wickedness that was going on back then.
And there was a lot of it too.
So anytime you guys pop up and try to speak on these things, then that's why Elder Tahar jumps right on it and said, nope, this is how it went down, and this is how it went down. You know, and then certain things Elder Gabar remembers, certain things Elder Rakai remembers, and some of us remember certain other things too. You know? Because the bottom line, man, the Most High is going to deal with all of you. That's why you, Lahab, the Lord, that counsel that you kept avoiding, you know, with King Mashiach and High Priest Ariah, it's being brought up against you right now, and it was brought against you that day when we saw you at a Sam's Club.
Mm-hmm.
You know, all them years you were skating, you know, with all that money you stole, and that day the Lord brought judgment upon you because Elder Tahar said, well, the Most High is going to deal with you. You know, and then Elder Gabar said, look at you, man, you're still all dressed in black. And then Elder Rakai said, he said, look, what happened to your central command? Where'd your central command at now?
Yeah, he was just getting cut,
you
man.
Know?
He had his head down that day. He couldn't even buy that big TV. That $5,000 TV set, man.
God.
Hey, give me Titus 1.
Hey, so that's a lesson to you young brothers, man. Sooner or later, the Most High, he deals with bullshit, man. He'll get to you, man. All you scoffers and scorners, you delight in putting shit on the comment board. I'm telling you, sooner or later, one day, the Lord is going to visit you, man, when you least expect it. You keep doing your bullshit.
Yeah, this is speaking about the bishop, but it applies to all of us, elders, and all of us, because you come up in that order. Titus 1:8 on down. We're going to read to, I guess we can read to the 15, maybe even the whole, yeah, down to the end.
All right, this is the book of Titus, chapter 1, verse 8. But a lover of hospitality, a lover of good men, sober, just, holy, temperate, holding fast the faithful word as he hath been taught, that he may be able by sound doctrine both to exhort and to convince the gainsayers. For there are many unruly and vain talkers and deceivers, especially they of the circumcision, whose mouths must be stopped, who subvert whole houses, teaching things which they ought not for filthy lucre's sake. And you see that going on. It says, one of themselves, even a prophet of their own, said, the Cretans are always liars, evil beasts, slow bellies. This witness is true. Wherefore rebuke them sharply, they may be sound in the faith, not giving heed to Jewish fables and commandments of men that turn from the truth. And that's what happened. You had certain men that, you know, because they had leadership positions, they gave a commandment against the scriptures, and it was against the truth, like the hell thing, the virgin birth thing. You know, Mary never had sex. You know, those are all BS, Jewish, or not even Jewish. Those are just fables, you know, because they go back to them ancient Babylonian, Egyptian, and them different Canaanite pagan deities.
Yep, that's right.
You know, so it says, not giving heed to Jewish fables and commandments of men that turn from the truth. You know, and that's what happened. It happened with Lahab, Yashawan, and them. That happened with a whole bunch of different guys.
It's happening with Nate.
Yep.
With Nate, with Bubble Eye Blackfish.
Yep.
With 14th Street Moron. You know?
That's right.
They're the modern examples now. And just like the Lord dealt with Yashawan and Lahab and all them phonies, the Lord going to deal with you niggas. You know? As a matter of you got any more?
Yeah, a little more. It says, okay. Unto the pure, all things are pure. But unto them that are defiled and unbelieving is nothing pure. But even their mind and conscience is defiled.
Mm-hmm.
They profess that they know the Most High, but in works they deny him.
Yeah, like an example of in works they deny him. You don't go out and teach.
That's right.
You know, the works is you're supposed to go out and teach, man. Every week you're supposed to go out there and teach. Go out there on the street and teach the word.
That's right.
You're supposed to set up a camp. You know, that is part of the work. But a lot of you guys, you don't do the works. So that's a evidence of you denying Yahweh Shem Yahshai. You know? Then it says, being abominable and disobedient, and unto every good work reprobate. Now, some of you guys are saying, well, the internet is the highway to, the highway to go and teach. Well, the scriptures say to be in season, to teach in season, out of season. How can that be applied to the internet?
That's right.
That means you're supposed to be out there in the open. That means you're supposed to be out there in the elements, the hot and the cold elements.
That's right.
But you guys have found a way to get around that. So like the scriptures say, being abominable and disobedient unto every good work, which this is a good work, a reprobate. Which the word reprobate means a mind void of judgment. All right? I got a precept. This is for all you phony-ass niggas who really don't belong in Israel. This is the book of Matthew 15 and 13 and 14. But he answered and said, this is Yahweh Shai speaking, every plant which my heavenly Father have not planted shall be rooted up. All right? Let them alone. They be blind leaders of the blind. And if the blind lead the blind, both shall fall into the ditch. So that's plain, man. Plain and simple.
I got something to back you up on that one. This is St. John 15 and 1. I am the true vine, and my Father is the husbandman. Every branch in me that beareth not fruit, he taketh away. And every branch that beareth fruit, he purgeth it, that it may bring forth more fruit. Now you are clean through the words which I have spoken unto you. Abide in me, and I in you. As the branch cannot bear fruit of itself, except it abideth in the vine, no more can ye, except you abide in me. I am the vine, you are the branches. He that abideth in me, and I in him, the same bringeth forth much fruit. For without me you can do nothing. If a man abide not in me, he is cast forth as a branch, and is withered, and men gather them and cast them into the fire,
yeah, and
is
withered.
They are burned.
If I may, and is withered, a good example is HODC. They're not abiding in Yahweh Shem Yahshai. They may think they are, but they're not. And you can see that they're withered. They look dead, man. When you look at them, they look dead. You can see the spirit of the Lord, Yahweh Shem Yahshai, is not dealing with them. That's why Barack thinks that Obama is the Antichrist. All right? That's why he cannot get the understanding of Cornelius. Because he's withered. If he was rooted in Yahweh Shai, he would understand that Cornelius is a Hebrew Israelite.
Yeah, I got a scripture. This is in the Apocrypha of Wisdom of Solomon 1 and 3 and 4. It says, for forward thoughts separate from the Most High. That's why you can't get these understandings, man.
Mm-hmm.
And his power, when it is tried, reproveth the unwise. So you're unwise, so that's why you're being reproved. For into a malicious soul, wisdom shall not enter, nor dwell in the body that is subject unto sin.
Yeah.
Because you guys are trying to get together, and one of you guys had made a statement. I don't know if it was on a comment board or one of you guys had made a statement, or a couple of you guys, you know, why, let's get together and let's, y'all, if y'all got that now, let's get together so y'all can break it down to us. You got a malicious soul. So that'll be a waste of time, man. You got to go to the cellars. All right? That's the name of the topic. Oh, and let's end it on that. Since you mentioned that, give me Matthew 25, and let's read that whole parable.
Matthew 25 and 1. Then shall the kingdom of heaven be likened unto 10 virgins, which took their lamps and went forth to meet the bridegroom. And 5 of them were wise, and 5 were foolish. They that were foolish took their lamps and took no oil with them.
That's you guys. That's why you're stuck on stupid. That's why you can't break down basic, simple scriptures.
It says, they that were foolish took no lamps, took their lamps and took no oil with them. But the wise took oil in their vessels with their lamps.
We are the wise. Now somebody, you cheat, oh, you can't be calling yourself wise. You ain't the wise. How do you know? Well, we're breaking down them scriptures, you dummy.
That's how we know.
Unlike yourself.
That's how we know.
It says, while the bridegroom tarried, they all slumbered and slept. And at midnight, there was a cry made. Behold, the bridegroom cometh. Go ye out to meet him. Then all those virgins arose and trimmed their lamps. And the foolish said unto the wise, give us of your oil, for our lamps are gone out. But the wise answered, saying, not so, lest there be not enough for us and you, but go rather to them that sell and buy for yourselves. And while they went to buy, the bridegroom came, and they that were ready went in with him to the marriage, and the door was shut. Afterward came also the other virgins, saying, Lord, open to us. But he answered and said, verily I say unto you, I know you not. Watch therefore.
That's what the Lord is going to tell you guys, Barack and Bunyamian. That's what the Lord is going to tell you guys. And I'm going to say, I'm going to put this out here, man. You guys in the other camps, man, the camp that the Most High is dealing with is GMS. So it behoove you to get on our good side and try to get in this camp. You're going to have to start at the bottom, you know.
Yeah,
but at least you'll have all the breakdowns of the scriptures, man. You know, you with the mother camps, man. That's not a good move.
Yeah, you'll be occupied in prophecy too.
Con,
because we're occupied in prophecy, as you can see.
Your eyes will be open. See, your eyes are not open with these guys.
Yeah, they're bullshitting. Them other guys are bullshitting, man. They, you know, come on, let's put it plain. They're bullshitting.
This is Proverbs 21:20. There is treasure to be desired. And oil in the dwelling of the wise. But a foolish man spendeth it up. That's this knowledge, the oil. Back in Matthew 25:13. Watch therefore, for you know neither the day nor the hour wherein the Son of Man cometh. And that's the end of the parable there. You know, and that's basically why we watch for the prophecies. Because the Lord gave us what to look for in these times, you know, before he comes back. You know? And that's why we have our lamps trimmed up and burning, you know, like the Lord.
Burning bright.
Yeah.
That's right.
Well, the light on the city cannot be hid. And that's why Sarnetta came to that light. Sarnetta saw that light. This is the book of Psalms 23.
Oh, no, Sarnetta's cutting the last video he did. He's cutting them black conscience guys. You guys are supposed to have this now. He said the black consciousness community took a beating this year. 2013 from the Hebrews, you know. And he said, you guys ain't even out there on the highways and the byways, man. He said, look, I'm going to start going out there. I'm going to go out there and I'm going to push this word, man. You know?
There you go.
All that comedic shit. Hey, yeah. But he's coming around, man.
Yeah.
He cutting the hell out you guys, and he brought attention to us, man. And a lot of you people that's watching us, the Hebrew Israelites, you talking shit about us. But guess what, man? The Most High gonna destroy you, man. Yeah. On that shit, ain't no Pharaoh coming back from the fucking grave or some tomb to come back and save your black ass. Because if that was the case, he would have did that shit a long time ago. He would have did it in slavery, man. There wouldn't be no 12 years of slave,
right?
Because Tutankhamun would have jumped up out and killed the white man for you, man.
That's right.
So when is Pharaoh going to come back? Huh?
Yeah. He sounded like my man in the movie. There's only despair in this place.
I will keep myself hearty till freedom is opportune.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
Proverbs 4:18. But the path of the just is as a shining light that shineth more and more unto the perfect day.
Hey, man.
Hey, that's it. And with that.
Oh, I got a free
one. Okay, go ahead. Like go ahead.
This is a good one. Psalms 23:5. It says, Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over.
Yep,
going back
it.
To the oil, you know.
That's right.
Our cup
that's
is right. running over. That's We're right. trying to share
right.
it with you.
That's right. And you're glad you guys be watching us to see any new prophecies or new breakdowns or new things that are out there, man. You know, you be watching us, man, you know.
Our cup is running over.
But like I said, if you're not of the elect, which we're not saying we are definitely of the elect. We pray that we are the elect, man.
Can.
It says give diligence to make that calling and election sure. That's why we're diligent, man.
That's right.
So with that, I'm going to say shalom. Keep watching
to the elect.
If you want to learn, learn the prophecies and the scriptures of the Most High. Keep watching.
That's right.